happened across this guy thanks to some friends in common. And I can only say that the first time I met him, it was in a high-end bar, needless to say, in a hotel. That was my choice, not his.
Continuing the tradition.
In Toronto. And he comes in, of course, with that great clunky yellow guitar case. And I said, you can't play that in here. I can't play it anyway. But we talked about the guitar and the dreams. And it was very quickly clear that this was an extraordinary bit of idealism mixed with practical results. So it went from there. We hit it off. The guitar just blew me away. That is the idea of it. And those of you who know me know I'm a dreadful old-fashioned Canadian nationalist, even a Federalist. And this just seemed to strike a chord, so to speak. I didn't rehearse that. And I thought, you know, there's something very special here. And we're in. And I think it was almost that simple. And I learned later that after I left, he raced out, bought a bottle of champagne, and drove it over to the CBC where Bill Richardson, who had actually suggested we get together, and he, out of plastic glasses, it's the CBC after all, drank this champagne. And I was going to say, well, it's your turn, except it appears you're too late because we've done it. So this is a toast to a fabulous human being, great guy. Doesn't play guitar, but he talks the blues streak, and he's very good at it, and has fulfilled the dream.
Thank you so much.
Bravo.
Thanks everyone for coming. This is awesome. This book is more beautiful than I ever could have imagined. It's such a this project is sort of crazy and it's raggedy and it has not been smooth sailing at all. But this last part of it in making a book has been so smooth and so cooperative. Just a really great experience. And then you'll see that Constable Mills there has the coin that has also recently come out from the Royal Canadian Mint. We always like to have the cops look after the money. It's a good thing. And I'll just, actually, I can let you know why Scott's here too, because it's also part of the reason we're here. Luminato is coming up, and they're making great use of the guitar in the festival. And that really kicked off last year when Scott got Kedry Brown and Jesse Pacho, also known as Bubblz and Phade, to do a mural of the guitar with Luminato's help on the back of Lee's Palace. So if you're ever on Bloor Street, you go down the little alley next to the Tim Hortons there. There's a terrific mural that they did in celebration of this guitar. That's featured in the book, and along with a whole bunch of other stories connected to this guitar. Thanks so much to all of you who have played a part in this, and all of you for coming, and please enjoy, and make sure you don't leave without getting your